Hi, and welcome to Sensor Tower's ASO 101 training video. My name's Karen, and today I'll be walking you through ASO best practices for both iOS and Android apps. Before we dive in, I wanted to let you know about three great resources you'll have access to throughout your ASO efforts. The first of these is our ASO Academy. You can sign up directly on our website. With this additional training course, you'll receive daily emails that will walk you through a variety of topics that will help you get started with all of your ASO efforts. The second resource I wanted to mention is the Sensor Tower blog. Our blog is a terrific way to stay up to date on any major changes in ASO best practices, new Sensor Tower features, and industry knowledge. Last but not least, you can always reach out to our support team, that's support@sensortower.com, with questions about the platform or about ASO in general. Let's get started with a definition of App Store optimization. ASO is a practice of improving an app's characteristics in order to increase visibility and increase organic downloads. There are two important things to note from this definition. The first, ASO is a process. It isn't a set-it-and-forget-it strategy. The reason we say this is that conditions in the App Store can change frequently, so your keyword rankings need to be monitored continuously over the lifespan of an app. Second, a common misconception is that ASO is only about keywords. Keywords are definitely a very big part of it, but once someone finds your app, it needs to be visually appealing enough that they will go ahead and download it. Compelling icons and screenshots will help convince a person to choose your app instead of a competitor's. So why should you care about ASO? These two quotes really highlight the fact that search is the number one channel for user acquisition. Lots of companies spend millions of dollars on user acquisition, but with ASO, you can really shore up your app and generate these conversions organically. First off, let's talk best practices for navigating Apple's search algorithm. There are a few things you can directly control in terms of your app's ranking. The first is your app title. Words in your app's title will be weighted by far the most heavily of all search terms. You have up to 255 characters, so that gives plenty of room to add your most important keywords to the title. Here's an example of what we're commonly seeing in the App Store. This is the app profile for Musician Guitars app. You'll notice that they've included the short name, a dash, and then a logical phrase that includes several of their most important keywords. With iOS apps, you also have control over your keyword list. Here you have 100 characters available. There are a couple of things to note here. First, you don't need to repeat keywords from your title or publisher name, as you'll automatically rank for these things. When choosing keywords, you'll want to select relevant, high-traffic terms that your app can rank well for. Other edge cases for which you will rank include in-app purchase terms and plural versions of your keywords for the English language. Last, you'll also rank for phrases. The Apple algorithm will automatically create every possible permutation of your keywords, so you'll rank for long-tail keywords as well. As some of you might know, Google Play has a much different algorithm. The title, though, is still our number one factor for search terms, so again, we recommend putting some of your most important keywords in this area. With Google Play, the main difference is that the terms your app ranks for will come directly from the description. As a result, a best practice is to mention crucial keywords multiple times. This is what we call creating keyword density, which will be familiar to those of you who have worked with search engine optimization, or SEO, in the past. With the Google Play algorithm, volume and quality of reviews can have a significant effect on rank. You'll want to do some research on effective ways of prompting your users to leave feedback. Because reviews are so important, they're also a great place to get keyword ideas. If a particular phrase keeps cropping up in your reviews, chances are that's how your app users are commonly describing the product, so it would likely be good language for you to include. On the list of pros and cons with the Google algorithm, an obvious con would be that the algorithm does not guarantee you will rank for all of your keywords. The flip side, though, is that it's really easy to test and iterate, since there is a very brief submission and review period. Since good ASO means continuous iteration, you can quickly and easily trade out words or strategies that aren't working well for you. Now that we've talked through our ASO basics and best practices, it's time to take a look at an effective workflow you can use to really get the most out of Sensor Tower. The first thing you'll want to do is track all of your existing keywords so you can see how you're faring in the rankings. You should also track important phrases as well. This will give you a great idea of where you want to focus your energy right off the bat. Step 2 is to optimize your existing keywords, to scrub them for any redundancies and eliminate any words or phrases that aren't performing well. This will free up characters that you can use for better keywords. For the research component, there are several modules in Sensor Tower you'll want to use. I'll walk you through these momentarily and also discuss traffic and difficulty scores. Once you submit your app, spend the next 2 to 3 weeks monitoring your progress. Then keep iterating. Optimize what you have, research new additions, resubmit, and check the data daily. Note that you can still start ASO work even if your app isn't published yet. Add the app of a close competitor and use their performance as a measuring rod. This way, you'll have awesome metadata from your very first submission, an advantage many app publishers are missing out on. Now let's hop over to the dashboard to see what this workflow looks like in the platform. When you first log into your Sensor Tower account, you'll want to add all apps you're interested in tracking. Make sure to select the correct platform and enter your app's name here. In this example, let's take a look at the popular app Clash of Clans. Use the flag dropdown in the top right-hand corner to switch between countries. Things like category rankings and keyword rankings are country-specific, so you'll need to optimize for each market. In the dropdown below your email address, you'll see an option to attach your iTunes and Google Play credentials. I highly recommend doing this to save yourself time and also back and forth between platforms. The credentials will pull all of your existing iOS keywords into the dashboard in real time, as well as your iOS and Google Play downloads and revenue. To pull over your existing iOS keywords, you'll want to use the Keyword Optimization module. You can use the Load button here to pull them directly over from iTunes Connect, or you can simply copy and paste the full list into the field. Click Optimize and the dashboard will show you any opportunities we feel that you have to correct things that go against ASO best practices. To remove a word from your list in the dashboard, simply click directly on it. When I scroll down, you'll notice we show a full list of the keywords you've just entered. As we mentioned in the workflow, you'll want to track all of your existing keywords right off the bat by using the Track All Keywords button towards the bottom of the screen. Now that I've tracked my existing keywords, when I go to the Keyword Rankings module, the data for those terms will have been populated in graph and chart form. In the top left-hand side, I can specify a custom date range across which I want to view the data for each of my keywords. I can also change the information that appears on my graph by selecting a different term. I'll scroll to the bottom where my list appears, click directly on the term, and the graph will update to show me my historical rankings. With the keyword rankings chart, you'll notice that we have the ability to add tabs. I would recommend creating tabs for different types of groupings, including previous keywords, phrases that you're interested in ranking for, and any custom type of list you'd like to track. Many people will create custom tabs to track the keywords of their close competitors. We discussed 3 things to consider when choosing new keywords, and those were relevance, difficulty, and traffic. Relevance involves a human component, so you'll have to use your best judgment on what terms make sense in conjunction with your app. For traffic and difficulty, our data science team has created some really powerful algorithms to help you determine if a word or even a phrase is a good option. First, let's look at the difficulty score. The difficulty score looks at the popularity of a keyword and the number of apps ranking for that keyword. It also takes into consideration reviews and ratings for apps using popular terms, along with the age of those apps and whether or not the app names are exact or partial matches for the search. Ultimately, it's telling you how hard it is to rank for the top 10 spots on any given term. When you're just getting started, you'll want to target words with a lower difficulty score, but you will be able to grow in this area as your app generates more downloads. To determine the right difficulty score for you, look at terms for which you are currently ranking in the top 10 or ranking very well for. Average together the difficulty scores for those terms, and this will approximate what you should be looking for. The traffic score is an estimate of potential traffic, and it ranges from 0 to 10, with only a few very popular keywords like Facebook having a score of 8 or over. A healthy traffic score for a single term is anywhere 4 or above. This algorithm contains a number of components. Some of those items are things like auto-suggestions when typing in the store, frequency of word usage and common crawl data, and also the length of these terms, or consequently how difficult they are to type on an iPhone keyboard. We also include things like traffic estimates from the web. The keyword research and keyword suggestion modules will be wonderful places for you to hunt for better keywords. You'll be provided with the traffic and difficulty scores, as well as a comprehensive list of all apps competing for that term, in ranking order. You can also use this field to search for particular phrases. Keyword suggestions pulls from a list of your seed keywords and makes intelligent suggestions based on the type of app you're using, your competitors' apps, and a variety of other algorithmic components. Keyword Spy is another wonderful tool to generate ideas for your next metadata update. This view displays every term for which an app is currently ranking, so you can get a really good idea of what choices your competitors are making and whether or not those choices seem to be working. Since we're looking at Keyword Spy, I want to point out that competitive analysis is a very important aspect of ASO. Not only can you get ideas from what your close competitors are doing, you can compare your progress to theirs directly and easily visualize any drastic changes. Use the Track Competitors module to add any app you want to compare yourself against. Once you've tracked that competitor, their information will appear alongside your own in modules like Category Rankings, and also in the Keyword Rankings module. The last thing I'll speak to today in terms of your day-to-day action items is the importance of localization. Translating your metadata to the corresponding language of each market can really have a big impact on your organic downloads. Localization should definitely be a priority for you if you're expanding into new App Store countries. Our Keyword Translation module will help you get started with your localization efforts, but the most important thing I wanted to demonstrate now is the character counter feature. You'll see that a direct translation of my keyword string results in wildly different character counts for other languages. So if I just directly translated this and resubmitted in China without doing any additional research on keywords for that country, I'd be missing out on quite a few additional characters. This really demonstrates the necessity of optimizing for each market in which your app is present. This concludes our ASO 101 training. Stay tuned for more videos on additional sensor tower features and pro tips on how to make the most out of your ASO efforts. Thanks and have a great day!